Okay, as a request, someone has asked me to build another preset for them so they can use them in their band, and it's for Why Can't This Be Love by Van Halen. I didn't know the track, but I do now. and the system uses a synth block running two sawtooth waves, like this. And you're going to use the voice 1 and voice 2 sawtooth. Voice 1 pan to the left, and voice 2 sawtooth and pan to the right. Okay, other controls are adjusted, but we're going to do them in a minute because I need to do it in a way that, because I haven't made notes, I'm doing it systematically. Next step is to create a parallel chain after this, and that's going to go right to the end. One thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a volume block at the end, because as we drop in more effect blocks into the chains, they're all stereo, so they're going to merge kind of their own signal and create a left and right sound. And I want to maintain that the top chain is always to the left and the bottom chain is always to the right. So I'm using volume blocks 1 and 2. Like that. Right, next step is to add a couple of mixers in to separate the left and right for the individual chains. I'm obviously using row 2, so we're going to get gain 2, move it to the left, and do the same with another mixer. I ended up over there. Hang on a minute. Right, sorry about that. Let's have a quick listen to it now. Sounds pretty horrendous at the moment. I think we might have to take one of the voices down a whole octave. The more voices you have, more different octaves, the more the flanger that I'm going to put in a minute interacts with the signal. Next step is to add a drive block to both chains, and we're going to keep always the same drive blocks, but just make different adjustments to the individual blocks. It's the treble mid boost type. Just turn up the drive on both and a bit of tone. Just going to turn the volume down a touch and try it. Okay. Next step is to add the flanges in. So it's quite a basic preset, really. And turn the rate to quite low, maybe 0.3 on each, and turn the depth up to about 75. Make sure they're different. It gives a different sound for the left and the right. That's flange number 2. Too much feedback, I think. And there's a kind of morphing sound in the original, and I'm going to recreate that by adding 2 filters, 1 on each row again, and we want a notch type like that, but 4th order, and you want the frequency controlled by LFO 1A and filter 2, same settings, but the frequency controlled by 1B. And while we're at it, have it go straight into control, adjust the phase slightly, and then set the rate to quite low, point two or something. One of the things, I'm going to add a third voice, and it's going to be a triangle type, because triangle has more higher frequency sounds coming through. So because of that, I'm going to turn its level down quite considerably. I just realised, I said I didn't make notes, but I have actually built this preset already and it's stored somewhere else, but both of the voices on the synthesizer need to be set down to minus 12. And voice number 3 needs to be on 0, as we've got it. And also one of the drive levels needs to be much higher, like that. Maybe turn the tone down a bit because it was getting a bit noisy. The rest of the settings that you can do is just clean it up, really. Change the time somewhat on some of the different effects, and also adjust the duty between. Not that one. That's number 3. Adjust the duty slightly relative because they're obviously running the same frequency and the same type of waveform. You generate some difference there with the duty and the tuning. That's it basically. That's as far as I've got on it. Copy these settings and you can generate your own version, probably a better one. Not very exciting. Next step is to try a guitar, so I'm going to pick up my nearest guitar, unplug the cable, and plug it in. That's the guitar running through. There's not much else to say, really. Let's just compare it with the other one I created. We'll store that, and we'll go back to number 44. Oh yeah, I did a compressor. The same on here. That's as far as I can go, I think. The compressor certainly, well, it strengthens the signal up. If you turn the threshold quite far down, you see how the gain is adjusting. Finishing touches are to add a gate. There we go. Silence. So that's it basically. Store your work and go and play it.